Fraction bars are a part-to-whole area model for fractions. A common model for many years has been pies or pizzas. One set of fraction bar activity mats has both of these models, pies and bars. One advantage of the fraction bars model is it can be used for measurement and also for locating fractions on a number line. These two ideas will be illustrated in this video. Let's begin using fraction bars to measure the length of some objects. Now the length of this pencil is longer than 7 parts out of 12. We've got to increase the number of shaded parts. Okay, this looks like we have it here. This pencil is approximately the same as the length of a 9 out of 12 parts of a fraction bar, so we'll say its length is 9 twelfths bars, or 9 twelfths of a bar. Let's look at a little longer pencil here. Now we'll try 10 out of 12. That's not quite long enough. Let's use 11 out of 12. Sometimes we'll have to do a little rounding here. This is a little bit more than 11 out of 12, but you can see that it's less than half of the next space. So we're going to say that the length of this pencil is going to be 11 over 12 bars. Almost a whole bar. Next, we will measure with the bars to construct a number line. This is the beginning of the number line from 0 to 2. And between 0 and 1, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 12 parts. This length from 0 to 1 has the same length as one whole bar. So we can use the shaded amounts of the orange bars to write the numbers under the max on this number line. Since 2 parts of this bar are shaded, the shaded amount represents the fraction 2 twelfths. So we can write 2 twelfths. We need this max. Now a common mistake for some students is to think the fraction for this max should be 3 twelfths. They count the max 1, 2, 3. But it's the spaces we need to count, and the shaded amounts of the fraction bars can help us to remember this. So we can continue to use the shaded amounts of fraction bars to write other numbers between 0 and 1. We have 4 parts shaded. This is going to be the fraction 4 twelfths. And we'll just continue along here. This is going to be 6 twelfths. We'll do every other mark here. This is 8 twelfths. 10 twelfths. Now, eventually we're going to get up here to where we have a whole bar, 12 twelfths. And instead of writing 12 twelfths here, we'll write 1 because this is one whole bar. Now we can continue to use fraction bars to get the numbers for the max between 1 and 2. So this max that's here is going to be one whole bar and 2 twelfths. So we're going to write 1 and 2 twelfths. Now this number is a mixture of the whole number 1 and the fraction 2 twelfths. Now we can continue as before. We'll write the mixed numbers. 1 for this max is going to be 1 and 4 twelfths. 1 and 6 twelfths. 1 and 8 twelfths. 1 and 10 twelfths. And eventually we're going to have 2 whole bars. And because of that, we write the number 2 rather than 1 and 12 over 12. Now this is only the beginning of the number line, and it can be extended to 3 bars, 4 bars, and so forth. This activity will help students connect the region model for fractions to the more abstract number line model. Now a fraction bar has a length of 6 inches, and this 2 bar number line has a length of 12 inches. and just fits onto a standard 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. Now this is a Black Line Master from the grades 5 to 8 Fraction Bars Teacher's Guide, and these can be run off for students so that each student can form their own number line by writing in the fractions and mixed numbers. Let's use the number line for a few more measurements. Here's a pencil that has a length of more than 1 2/12. It's almost 1 3/12, very close. So rounded off, the length of this is going to be 1 3/12 bars. Another thing that's common in the classroom is the standard sheet of paper. This length is 1 5/12 bars. The length of 1 10/12. Now you could also convert these measurements into inches because each space on the orange bars is 1/2 inch, so you've got 1 inch from 0 2/12, and you can see that this is going to be 11 inches. This is an 8.5 by 11 inch sheet of paper. Now working in pairs, students can use two of the number lines to measure larger objects. Let's look at a game from fractionbars.com that uses mixed numbers. In Fraction Darts, we will select the option of one player, a difficulty level of 1, and type the player's name. The height of the dart board is mixed numbers. It goes from 1 4/9 to 4 1/2. The player approximates the location of a balloon, types in a number, clicks throw dart. Nice shot.
Thanks.
In this lesson, we introduced measuring mixed numbers and a fraction number line. The number line is a common model for fractions, but it is more abstract than the region model. In the activity in this video, we showed that students can build a fraction number line by using the more familiar region model. This connection of the region model to the number line model helps students to see what fractions go with the points on this line.